Okay, hello, this is Clemens from Autotonic, and in today's video I want to do something different. I've never used FL Studio really myself, and in this video I want to try to set up Autotonic with FL Studio, but I don't just want to use a regular connection. I want to route the raw MIDI signals of your actual hardware MIDI keyboard controller into FL Studio, so we can control it then from FL Studio. Or like from the piano roll, we can only play the white notes and toggle also header switchings from the piano roll, or record the initial raw MIDI signal into FL Studio, so we then can edit it afterwards, non-destructive way. Okay, so for this I need two MIDI ports. I have already set them up here in this case. So we are just going to open Autotonic here, and also we are going to open already FL Studio. So in FL Studio it's all completely reset now, and as said, I've never really used this software, this DAW. But let's jump into it. I've looked a little into it, what's required. So first of all, for this case of demonstration, we only gonna need two tracks. So we will need one our raw MIDI track, and we will need one track that will host our VST, our instrument here. So for this case, we will replace this first with MIDI out instrument generator plugin. This is a FL Studio proprietary generator that allows to send signals to external devices like hardware synthesizers, or in this case we will send the signals to Autotonic. And on the second case we will insert here our FL standard keys, so in this case we have something to monitor our signals. Wait until it's load and change it here. Okay, great. So don't claps won't be needed. Okay, great. So we have only these two tracks we will consider here now. And so the first thing we're going to do is to take a look into our MIDI settings here. And we want to select our, there is already here, this is the XKey 737 number 2. This is my MIDI hardware MIDI controller that I'm using now for the input signals. So when I press it, we can see here the signals are represented as it is set to be enabled here, and as to be the active one. But we have here these internal arbitrary port assignments in FL Studio, and we will choose the number 1. So we remember our input keyboard is the first step, is port 1. And now we close it and make sure that this MIDI out channel track, our raw MIDI track, basically, that this track will only receive notes from all of our XKey 37 number 2 ports. So that this track will respond to this particular input. So secondly, we want to check the MIDI out plugin, and it has to send to a dedicated port. So we have to go to the options MIDI settings menu again and define an output port. And in this case, as I said, I've already defined these two output ports here, MIDI port 1 and MIDI port 2, however you may name these or how are they called on your system. And we will call this port 2 internally assignment in FL Studio. And this is has not to be enabled here, and close this and make sure that this MIDI out plugin here, this MIDI out plugin will send now to the port 2. So in case when we press now on our hardware MIDI controller, we already should be sending to the port 2 assigned to the ESC driver MIDI port 1, which is in this case Autotonic's. If we go to Autotonic, then we can select here MIDI port 1 as well here, and we can already see that the signals are represented here. So nothing else is selected, only MIDI port 1. So signals are routed through FL Studio's MIDI out plugin into Autotonic by the use of this ESC driver MIDI port. So what we're going to do now is select eventually a little more recognizable scale here, and eventually a second already. And what we're going to do now is to set the output routing to be routed to the IC driver MIDI port number 2. So when we go back now to FL Studio, then we can assign a second input. Now we have only our hardware MIDI controller assigned here, but we can also go scroll down the list here. Here it is already. It's already enabled. So be aware of this enable button as well. So you have to also enable, disable this part to be running in the background of FL Studio. And we will assign this part now to the next higher count. We have our input device number one, part one, arbitrary number, number two. And then there is this number, the MIDI part two, the incoming signals, the transpose signals will be now assigned to the FL Studio port 3. So in this case now, we want to assign FL keys, so our sound generating track, to be listening to the receive notes from, listening only to this IEC driver port 2 signals. So in this case, we already can hear signals that are generated in this case with the FL keys plugin here. But now we have to be also aware that we have to work on this track here. So we are going to work on the, if you would work on the FL keys, then we already can see the output transposing. But if we go back to the MIDI out plugin, then we can see what we are actually pressing on the hardware MIDI keyboard controller. So even our black key switchings, if we go to autotonic, our black key, whoops, there's unwanted. Then we can see that there are our black key switchings represented in FL Studio as well. And we can now as well control this directly from here. So if we press notes here, and this would mean a key switch. So we can even set, I'm not good at this here. And I know you guys rock with this, but I'm not. So drawing MIDI notes into the editor. And we could now, for example, set some melodies here. Okay. And even go back to autotonic. And it will automatically play this now, or we could also change then the scale directly from here, or go back to FL Studio and even add key switchings here, so like this. So you get the point. So now it's directly connected. Everything you do now on the piano roll in FL Studio will be directly represented at the input. The lower keyboard is the input in autotonic. And the output is directly sent through this part into FL keys, which is important to assign that the receive MIDI notes here. This is some important aspect here, as I just found out. Okay, and I think this will help some users, and if something is unclear, then just simply